Welcome back. In this video, we'll be comparing Erb palsy with Klumpke palsy. So on the left, we have Klumpke palsy, and on the right, we have Erb palsy. Klumpke palsy is caused by two main reasons, and they are upward force on the arm. Just imagine somebody shrugging their shoulders very strongly or excessively, and usually it happens in kids during labor. When the doctor is pulling out the baby, he just shrugged their shoulders excessively, and this will cause Klumpke palsy. Or it's also caused by grabbing a tree branch while falling. This is a very classic scenario for Klumpke palsy. Somebody's falling and he'd grab a tree branch as he falls and his arms would stretch up, and this will cause Klumpke palsy. While Erb palsy is mainly caused by lateral traction of the neck, Klumpke palsy is caused by damage to the lower trunk of the brachial plexus, and Erb palsy is caused by damage to the upper trunk of the brachial plexus. And the presentation of Klumpke palsy is total clawing of the hand, and the presentation for Erb palsy is waiter's tip arm. Here, as you can see, Klumpke palsy is presenting with total clawing of the hand and atrophy of the hand muscles. This will include the lumbricalis muscle, the interossei, the thenar and hypothenar muscles. Just remember that Klumpke palsy is clawing of the hand, and it's caused by climbing the tree. And Erb palsy presents as waiter's tip, and it will cause atrophy of the deltoid muscle, the supraspinatus and infraspinatus muscles, and the biceps muscle as well. Alright guys, so that's everything I've got today. Hopefully I made this easier for you, and when you come to the exam, you're going to be able to differentiate between them and answer them. I try to put the high yield information about these two topics here, so the main characteristic features of both. And yeah, see you guys later.